You're listening to the 1-2-3 show with me, Noreen Mayer, this Friday afternoon. Now let's turn to our next guest of today. We're talking to street photographer Miguel Marina, and he'll be talking about his latest book, Ping Pong Dialectic Street Vision, and he joins us live in the studio. And also, we are on Facebook Live as well, Noreen Mayer on RTHK Radio 3, and Miguel has brought his book along, so you'll be able to see some of his photos as well. So Miguel, welcome to the program, and thanks for joining us. Tell us, how did your journey to photography begin? How did you become a street photographer?
Well, I really liked being a photographer before, right? I was shooting before in Spain, and was a friend who introduced me to photography. But I then take photos. It was very random, like a very macro photos on landscape or a lot of different photos. But it was once I came here to Hong Kong, and I married my wife, and the honeymoon we went to Philippines. And in Philippines, she asked me, shall we bring the camera to Philippines? I said, oh, do you have a camera? Because I didn't have a camera at that time. And we brought the camera to Philippines, right? And I remember there was a lot of life in the streets in the Philippines. And I was taking photos. And once I arrived here to Hong Kong, I introduced those photos to one photographer. And he told me about the street photography. I said, street photography? What's that, the street photography, right? And well, after reading a little bit and listening to him, right? So I started to take photos in the street as a street photographer. The first photo I have here in my book was the first street photo I took. It was in Philippines, right? So it is the first one in the book. So
how many years ago was that?
Was not 6 years ago. Yeah, 2013. The first photo was on May 28th, and 6 years ago. So, but since that day, I take photos every day. And now, well, after my telephone, sorry, maybe. Now, after a while, now this is my work, and I shoot every day, and I teach how to observe. So, very good. This journey started once I married my wife, right? And now I am a photographer.
You are with a book.
Yeah. And now I have a book, right? Already in 17 different countries. So very good. So I feel so happy.
So what is the art behind observation? I mean, when you are a photographer, you've got your own eyes, you've got the camera lens. I mean, how do you observe to make sure that what you see is what you capture in your photos?
Yeah, well, observation is an art, of course, right? And this is, photography is an art, also as expression, right? And this is simple than music or painting, right? You need a lot of time for learning how to play the violin, right? Or how to be a good painter, right? But photography, you only need a finger, right? This is, and a camera, right? An observation, you have to train your eye every day, because I remember the first photo that I took was very random, right? And very basic photos. And I realized photos after photos, you have to communicate something with your photos, right? And this is what you learn, right? So you have to train your eye. But once you train, you see photos in everywhere. So I don't see now like a normal people. So I'm focused all the time for finding a scene, a story to tell with my camera. So it's an art of observation, and it's really, really good.
And it's a real sort of form of art, because I have photographer friends, and the way they capture the photo, and when I capture the photo, my timing is so bad. I didn't capture the right frame. So how do you teach that to your students, and how do you teach them how to observe?
Yeah, well, actually I didn't know how to teach, right? Once I show my photos, and I say, okay, I have to teach in my workshops or in my courses how to observe. So how can I teach, right? So I observe my photos, and I say, okay, I use this technique here. I use this technique here. I use a square format for that. I use a slow shutter speed for this, right? So I created some themes something like a 12 different lessons you can learn in 2 hours. In 2 hours, you know those lessons, and after that, you have to practice, right? But something like you have to, the thing is, if you see something different, right, you have to observe around it, right? I say, okay, what kind of things I can juxtapose with the main thing, right? The main thing is this guy who is sitting or whatever, or this corner. So look around it, right? And I say, okay, maybe if this guy is coming here, maybe I can tell some different stories. So it's all the time observing everywhere.
Yeah. Is there, Miguel, is there such thing as a perfect shot? Because sometimes, you know, you're waiting to get the perfect shot, but actually, this moment, the shot might look like this, but then if somebody walks, enters the frame, it changes the shot completely. And maybe that's also a perfect shot. So is there such thing?
So a lot of photos I have, and a lot of good photos also was because we were lucky, right? Because we were focused in another thing, right? And suddenly came something like a lot of doves or one dog or whatever, right? So who makes perfect your photo? So sometimes it's lucky, but you have to take, you have to have the camera, right, for being lucky also, right? And so many photos you see after that in the computer too, right? This is because maybe if you crop a little bit, some people say, no, because you cannot crop because the classic photographers didn't crop, but you can, of course. Now we have a computer, and sometimes once we crop it,
you make it a little bit more perfect.
And this is the thing, right? So it's the result you have where your image, right? So this is perfect also, right? So it's the thing is, if you shoot every day, you are going to learn how to take photos for sure.
Yeah. Is there a sort of, I'm just trying to think now compared to before we used to shoot on film, now everything or a lot of cameras are digitalized. So there's a lot more choices. You know, you take maybe 15 pictures of that shot. How do you decide shot number three is better than shot number 14, because everything is digitalized now, so it can be even too many choices.
Well, the thing is, don't shoot every day 300 photos like I did before, right? Because this is crazy. After that, you have to watch all of them in the computer, and becomes crazy to do that, right? But how to choose a photo? If one photo is able to communicate something, to tell a story, this is the photo you have to select, right? So you have to communicate something, right? For myself, I used to have some main elements in my photos, right? Like a humor, contrast, juxtaposition, composition, decisive moments, also geometry, symmetry. Those 7 elements, right? If you get 3 of them, it's a good photo.
Yeah.
So you can have more elements, right? But if you get 3 of those elements, it's a good photo. And the most important, I think, is the photo the people who is not photographer like. I remember my father doesn't know anything about photography, right? But some people who study in the university about photography, they tell me, no, because your composition is on the left or in the right, and this you have to do the left. And this is okay, because you know about techniques. But if I show one photo to my father or to my friends who don't know anything about photography, right, and they spend maybe 15 seconds reading that photo, and maybe they laugh or they think, I said, that's a good photo.
Yeah.
This is a good photo, right?
Because it's so genuine, you know, you don't have to understand everything about photography to appreciate photography. That's why people go to exhibitions,
sure,
who are not photographers, and they can appreciate the art also. Let's talk a little bit about your book also. Ping Pong, why is it called Ping Pong?
Well, it's called Ping Pong because I created a book with 80 photographs, right, made in diptych. So two photos, they have to have communication between themselves, right? So the photo on the left matches with the photo on the right.
And
right?
That is a technique. Yes, a diptych is when they mirror so you have a connection.
Yeah, it's a connection, right? You have to find, the viewer have to find the connection. And I know the viewer is going to stay from left to right and right to left, right? As in a ping pong match. That's the name of ping pong. It wasn't my idea. It was the idea of one lady, Sarah Green, right? Is the owner of one gallery. And I introduced her my work, and she really liked, but I have another name, right? Because I was so blind also. I said, I don't know. And in 5 seconds, she told me, Ping Pong. And actually, I love that name, right? Because of this, left and right, right and left, right? And also because I have to thank to Hong Kong, because this is like a national sport, right? Like in Hong Kong, right? And I have to thank
Chinese people love ping pong.
Yeah, sure. And I have to thank Hong Kong because Hong Kong made me photographer, right? So it's something like also because it's made in diptych, right? Left to right, right to left. And also because Hong Kong made me photographer, and I want to thank Hong Kong. Thank you, Hong Kong.
Let's talk about some of the photos then.
Sure.
I saw some of the samples that you sent me.
Uh-huh.
They're very different. Some are on the beach, some are on the train.
Sure.
And it's everyday life.
Everyday life, right? Because I wanted to put different scenes, right? Because you can find photos in everywhere, right? In Ping Pong, you can have decisive moments, humor, composition, a lot of lines, a lot of geometry, right? Because I want to show the people everywhere is a good place for taking photos. The most important is being there with your camera, right? That's all. So, well, I can show you maybe the first one, right? I told you before, this is the first photo I took, the street photography.
Yes, hold it up closer to our Facebook viewers.
So,
guys,
yeah.
We want you to see Miguel's book on Facebook, Noreen Mair on RTHK Radio 3. Talk us through those two pictures.
Okay, this is the first one I took, 2013, in my honeymoon with my wife. And what this is, as you can see, is two kids in Philippines playing. And what
the
they are
street,
playing, they are on
yes.
the street with the flip-flops. They were throwing away the flip-flops, right, in order to get one target. I don't remember what. Maybe it was an empty can of Coke or whatever, right? So, but they are having fun. They have friends, right? They are enjoying, and they are poor. And I combine with this photo is made, I took in Hong Kong, right? So in Hong Kong, well, people is more wealthy, right? But you can see the kids in Hong Kong don't play. Here you can find the ball is around
He's
here.
He's standing by himself.
Yeah, by
than
himself
playing.
And with a telephone, right? With a mobile, right? And the ball is here. So this is the first, well, I wanted to put this one first because it was the first photo I ever took before, right? So, and that one. And well, this is.
And that creates a story. You know,
you've got,
create
a story.
You've
so,
got the poor
yeah.
children,
so
but they're
left,
playing.
Right, right, left, right, as in a ping pong match. That's why, right? So, and well, this is the first diptych I use in my book. And the second one is I wanted to create a little bit of symmetry, right? Because I really like also here is, well, two people who are sat in the
on
a benches, right? So, but it's very symmetry. And also I found this story also a few years later, right? Also very symmetry, right? So ping pong is like, everyone is boring, right? But you can find symmetry in everywhere, right? So it's a lot of photos like this, right? So, and I can find more and, so this one is almost the same, right? It was in Portugal and in Spain, like everyone is bored, right? So the people just married, but they are not really happy, right? And they are walking around and the guy, his face is not really happy, right? And this is what maybe the marriage expects you, right? So you have to stay with your wife, like looking to the end, right?
But looking very miserable.
Yeah, very miserable. And, well, I wanted to create different stories and you can find a lot, right? So I can see here also is the old lady who is looking to the very young lady lying having a sun bath right here, and here the young lady who is working out and she's not looking at the old lady, right? So it's a lot of different stories, and the viewer, I am sure they are going to find the communication between those diptychs, right?
Yeah. You travel the world to take your photos. What sorts of connections do you have with the people you're taking the photo of? Do they know you're taking their photo?
No, actually, well, once you train your eye, also you train your invisibility, right? So you learn how to be invisible, right? So I'm very fast because once you know how to take
You're
this,
invisible. You
yeah,
have
invisible,
to take it very
right?
quick.
Invisible. So I don't use the visual contact, right? So I see the scene from far away, right? I approach them, I take the photo and bye-bye, right? So yeah, this is what I, and in everywhere, right? Well, and I took this book is in Korea, 90% of the photos are in Hong Kong, Also, we have Japan, Korea, Taiwan, Philippines, some in Portugal and some in Spain. My 90% is in Hong Kong, right? And it's easy here because it's a lot of life in the street, right? So, and people is very busy in Hong Kong, right? So it's very fast.
They don't see you.
Yeah, yeah, never.
Have you ever been spotted? I mean, I've heard that Hong Kong people are quite shy, and once they see you pointing a camera at them, maybe they... Have you ever been spotted before?
No, because, well, as I told you, right, it's...
You're very fast.
It's very fast, right? So they don't have time. And normally, where I have a very small camera, right, with me, right, it's like a pack of cigarettes. It's very small, right? So even, and I look like a tourist, right? I'm a wilo, right? I'm with a bag on my shoulder, right? And another, I look like a tourist, right? I'm always alone, right? And people think I'm a tourist. And the tourists are allowed to do whatever, right?
More but anyway, forgiving.
But, yeah, yeah, but anyway, it's a small camera. Right, you can shoot whatever, right? And people, even in my country, right, in Spain, don't know, right? So, but this is the thing is to take a moment, right, and make it beautiful.
How many photos do you take before you decide that this is the photo for the book? I mean, how many shots do you aim for, or is it really one or two shots?
Yeah, well, I selected 80 photographs among 800 photos I have at home.
Wow, okay, so 10%.
Yeah, yeah, but because the idea of the book, it was my wife told me, hey, you have to share your photos because I'm really tired to have, because my home in Hong Kong, every house is very small, right? So imagine 800 photos, A4 size, right? It's very, and my wife, come on, you have to share your work with the people, don't print more photos. And I said, okay, maybe one book can be good, right? So, and I have very good photos, but I wanted to create those diptychs, right? So, and so I select among 800, some 80, right? That's okay, this one. But already I'm working in the second book. Yeah. And because I have a good photos like those on the book, right? So, and I want to create and I want to show my work to everyone, right? So.
Yeah. Well, Miguel, before I let you go, how can people find out more about your book? How can they buy it? Have you got a website or Facebook? How can they get reach you?
Yeah, well, the book now is sold in my website. It's 3 W's, Miguelitor, miguelitor.net, right? So in my website, you can find it. And I think within 1 month, something like this is going to be available in some bookshops here in Hong Kong, right? Also in Amazon. But now because it's only 1 week with me, the book, right? So this I am the photographer, I'm the secretary, I'm the seller, I'm everyone now here. But yeah, in my website, you can buy it. Yeah.
Excellent. And we'll put a link of your website on my Facebook page as well. And you'll be able to see Miguel's latest book, Ping Pong, which is also dedicated to Hong Kong. Many thanks once again for your time today, Miguel. Pleasure to meet you. And I look forward to inviting you back on to talk about your second book after my maternity leave. Maybe.
Sure. I will be here. I think within 1 year, okay, we see each other again.
Excellent. Thank you so much for your
time.
Pleasure to meet you.
Thank you, Noreen.
Bye-bye. Time passed fast like the flash of